This is the first cool camera by SVBONY, and in this video I'll tell you everything you need to know if you're interested in buying this. I've been testing this for a few months now, and I've looked at it from almost every angle, and I want to share with you my thoughts and feelings about this new dedicated astronomy camera. Well, let's talk about its specs first. The SV405CC camera is SVBONY's first deep sky OSC camera. This is not monochrome, but OSC, which means it is designed to take RGB color images. Most important thing about any camera, cooled or not, is its sensor. This uses the infamous Sony IMX294 sensor. This is the same sensor you would find in ASI 294 MC Pro. It is very sensitive, and yes, it's back illuminated, which means it promises to be a good low light performance camera. You can expect 4.63 pixel size from this, which is quite modest. This sensor produces the excellent resolution of 4144 into 2822. The dynamic range of the sensor is quite high as well, 13 stops, which is more than the classic ZW ASI 1600, for example. Dedicated cameras are known for having low read noise, and this is no exception. This sensor produces only 1.2E read noise, which is excellent. Another thing to look for when buying an astronomy camera is quantum efficiency. This SV405CC camera produces a very high quantum efficiency value, which peaks at about 75%. This might not sound great, I want 100%, not 75%, but actually this is very good for these kinds of cameras. Your ordinary DSLR has a quantum efficiency of about 30 to 40%. So this camera has almost double quantum efficiency. This sensor has a whopping full well of about 63,700E, which is amazing. With this, you can be sure that bright stars won't saturate even under long exposures, and your images will have better signal-to-noise ratio. Another thing to note is that this camera sensor doesn't have any UV-IR cut filter inbuilt. It's open with all wavelengths. To take the full advantage of this camera, it's highly recommended to get an UV-IR cut filter. If you use it without UV-IR cut filter, your images will have bloated stars and look blotchy. I got UV-IR cut filter from SVBONY for a few bucks and would highly recommend it. Well, back to the camera. This sensor is supported by USB 3.0, which makes sure that your data is transferred with lightning fast speed. I've had cameras that use USB 2.0 and they are quite slow in comparison. But just in case you don't have 3.0 USB ports, this has 256 MB DDR3 memory buffer that helps you transfer the data smoothly. I must say, if possible, please don't use USB 2.0 ports because slow transfer speed can add to amp glow, unfortunately. I will come to amp glow in a moment, but for now, USB 3.0 makes all the difference. Just like ASI 294 MC, this camera comes with HCG mode, which by the way is short for high conversion gain. HCG reduces read noise to minimal levels at higher gain without loss to dynamic range. It's a win-win scenario. HCG kicks in at about 120 gain. At 120 gain, read noise goes under 2E, while dynamic range remains at 13 stops. Let's talk about its cooling system. For me, the main reason for buying this camera was its cooling abilities. Cooled cameras drastically reduce noise and allow you to take calibration frames with controlled temperature. This camera has a standard T TEC Tech cooling system. I usually use this at minus 5 degrees Celsius, although you can push it max to about 30 degrees below ambient temperature, which is rare for me because I live in a cooler region. With minus 5 degrees, I only use 30% of the power. I have absolutely no complaints with the cooling mechanism. It works as it should. It doesn't take long for the camera to cool down. By the way, to power the cooling system, you have to plug in the power supply which is provided with the camera. Now, one of the questions I was asked about this camera is, does this camera have an amp glow issue, which is a common problem for Sony IMX294 sensors? Well, I'm sad to say this, it does have amp glow issues. Let me show you a dark frame which clearly shows the issue. Now, is this a deal breaker? Well, not for me. Amp glow can be easily removed with dark frames, so it's not a big deal for me. Let me show you some of the images taken with this camera. Some are mine, others are by others, but they are all taken with this SVBONY 405cc camera. So there's a lot going for this camera. It's very sensitive, packed with awesome features, it cools well, and produces very nice, sharp-looking photos. In terms of price, I think this is currently the most affordable cooled camera in the market. This is compatible with most devices. There are many great strengths of SV405CC. But what about some weaknesses? Well, I've noticed two things. Firstly, the amp glow issue, which is not really a big issue for me. For some, it might be a deal breaker. Secondly, the power supply plug is somewhat loose. It did come off once when I was imaging remotely, which was the cause of some frustrations. That said, strengths far outweigh weaknesses. It's a great little camera, it's packed with great stuff, its specs are awesome, its sensor is sensitive and has a high dynamic range, its cooling works great, it produces very sharp images, it's not that expensive, so I would not hesitate to recommend this to you. Well, if you found this video to be helpful, please subscribe. If you have any questions about this camera or any other comment, feel free to write it in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.